Професор Дейвид Ван Есен, преподавател от катедрата по невронауки на Вашингтонския университет, гостува на Медицинския университет Варна по покана на колегите си от катедрата по анатомия и клетъчна биология.
My impressions are very positive in the few short hours that we've been here, but it was an impressive ceremony this morning to see the opening of the medical school. And in our visit so far in the anatomy and cell biology department, I've been very impressed by the technology that's available to the medical students.
Бележитият учен е главен изследовател в човешкия конектомен проект, в който са включени над 100 учени от Съединени американски щати и Великобритания. По време на посещението си във Варненския медицински университет, професор Ван Есен ще обсъди възможности за развитие на съвместни проекти със своите колеги тук. В рамките на гостуването си той прие да изнесе лекция пред студентите по медицина на тема човешката мозъчна кора, структура, функция и връзки.
I hope to encounter curiosity that they want to learn more about the human brain. The brain is the most complex processing, information processing device in the known universe. And the more we learn about the brain, the more we realize how much more there is to learn. So there's a wonderful future for exploration of the human brain.
Човешкият конектом е обширен проект за добиване на данни и изследване на мозъка.
Most importantly, from our recent studies, we have better maps of the human cerebral cortex. I think of myself as a cortical cartographer. That means I make maps of the cerebral cortex in ways that are analogous to how explorers of the Earth's surface have over thousands of years and in recent centuries have made better and better maps of our Earth's surface to identify the physical structures, the mountains and valleys and other geographic features, as well as the cultural and political landscape of how billions of people interact to establish human communities with political boundaries. For the human cerebral cortex, we want to make better maps of the physical structures, the folds that we call the cortical convolutions, that are much deeper crevasses than a typical mountain or valley range, but they're very similar conceptually. But we're particularly interested in what we call cortical areas that are equivalent to the political countries and other subdivisions of the Earth's surface. We want to make better maps of the human cerebral cortex and how it is functionally divided into distinct areas based on how billions of neurons interact and communicate with one another. And through the Human Connectome project that I've been involved in, we have been able to make better maps of the human cerebral cortex.
Това мащабно проучване се осъществява посредством високотехнологична апаратура.
The technology that has been most useful for the studies I'm referring to are magnetic resonance imaging, and that gives us the ability to look inside the skull and see the structure and function and connectivity of the inside the skull of the living human brain. And that's very powerful, but it is limited in the resolution, how fine-grained and detailed we can see. So it is also important that other studies are going on at other institutions around the world to make even better maps using histology slices of the brain post-mortem, that is after death, and to complement what we can learn from studying the living brain.
В цял свят десетки хиляди са учените, които се занимават с различни изследвания на проблемите на човешкия мозък, неговата функционалност, здраве и заболявания, разказа още бележитият учен. И все повече информация по темата ще обменят учените и студентите за напред.